In this session, we will discuss data encryption standard, that is DES algorithm. DES algorithm is a block cipher approach. A block cipher approach means the plain text is divided into different number of blocks and perform encryption operation to produce cipher text. And mainly this DES follows Feistel structure. DES follows Feistel structure. We already discussed Feistel structure, that is simply the plain text is divided into equal number of halves, perform operation on one half and perform some XOR operations. So we already discussed Feistel structure. Now coming to this DES, the size of the plain text is 64 bits. Size of the plain text is 64 bits. So if the size of plain text is 64, the size of cipher text is also 64 bits. Number of rounds, that is the number of times we have to perform encryption and or decryption, is 16. For DES algorithm we have 16 rounds and key size is 64 bits. In some books it referred to as 56 bits. Then I will explain later how 64 is converted into 56. Key size is 64 bits. So the key size is 64 bits and the number of rounds are 16. For each round we are providing a separate subkey. For each round we are providing a subkey. A subkey of size 48 bits. To perform encryption at each round we are providing a subkey. Each subkey is of size 48 bits. That is, from the 64 bits we are generating 16 number of subkeys. For each round you are providing one subkey. So 16 number of subkeys. Now first we will discuss the entire procedure of DES algorithm. First plain text the size of the plain text is 64 bits. The size of the plain text is 64 bits. First the plain text is applied into initial permutation. Plain text is applied into initial permutation. What is initial permutation? So generally the bits are represented in the format, that is 64 represented in 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, so on 63 64. The 64 bits plain text is represented in this format. Initial permutation means simply transposition of bit positions. Simply transposition of bit positions. After completion of this diagram we will discuss initial permutation. So after completion of initial permutation, again it produces 64 bits. The size of the plain text is 64 bits. Now these 64 bits are applied into round 1. 64 bits are applied into round 1. To perform some operation we need plain text of size 64 and we require a key. So parallelly we are generating a key. Initially size of key is 64 bits. Initially size of key is 64 bits. Now key is applied to permuted choice 1. Key is applied to permuted choice 1. By applying permuted choice 1, the size of the key is reduced into 56 bits. The 64 bits are converted into 56 bits. How we are performing conversion? Simply in the 1 to 64, all multiples of 8s are removed. That is 8, 16, 24, 32, 48, 54, 56. multiples of 8s are removed from 1 to 64 bits. It produces 56 bits. Whenever it produces 56 bits, these 56 bits are applied into left circular shift operation. 56 bits are applied into left circular operation. After completion of left circular operation, again it produces 56 bits and perform permuted choice 2. By performing permuted choice 2, it produces 48 bits. This is the procedure. 64 bits are applied into initial permutation and is applied to round 1. For round 1, one input is plain text, another input is key. Key of set 48. How we are getting 48? Initially 64 is applied into permuted choice 1. It produces 56 bits. Now these 56 bits are performed into left circular shift operation and applied to permuted choice 2. In permuted choice 2, again 6 bits are in, 6 8 bits are removed. It produces 48 bits. Now this is applied to 64 round 2. Similarly for round 2, 48 bits, permuted choice 2. Again left to circular shift. From this, again perform left to circular shift, it produces 56. Again perform permuted choice 1. Apply same procedure for 16 rounds. Same procedure for 16 rounds. After completion of 16th round, perform 32 bit swap. Perform 32 bit swap. 32 bit swap means left 32 bits and right 32 bits are simply interchanged. That is 1 to 32 becomes 33 to 64. 33 to 64 becomes 1 to 32. After completion of swapping, for finally perform inverse initial permutation. Inverse initial permutation. In inverse initial permutation, simply the positions of the bits are changed. That is, it is a transposition, and we are getting finally 64-bit ciphertext. We are getting 64-bit ciphertext. This is normal DES algorithm. So 64 bits are applied into initial permutation. At the same time, these 64 bits are applied into 16 rounds. Of each round, we are providing a key of size 48. That is, for each round, we are generating a new key. So from 64 bits, we are permuted choice 1, 56. From 56, 48. We are generating 16 keys for 16 rounds. After completion of 32 bits, inverse initial permutation, and produces ciphertext. Now we will discuss how initial permutation is performed, inverse initial permutation is performed, and the procedure of a single round. All rounds are performed in the similar fashion. We will discuss about a single round. Here permutation means simply changing of the positions. We already discussed the initially numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, so on. Suppose 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 63, 64, 62, 61. So initially the numbers are arranged in this format. By performing initial permutations, the bit positions are changed as 2, 4, 6, 8, 1, 3, 5, 7, 10, 12, 14, 16, 9, 11, 13, 15, 18, 20, 22, 24, 17, 19, 21, 23, 26, 28, 30, 32, 25, 27, 29, 31. Next, 34, 36,
38, 40, 33, 35, 37, 39, 42, 44, 46, 48, 41, 43, 45, 47, 50, 52, 54, 56, 49, 51, 53, 55, 58, 60, 62, 64, 57, 59, 61, 63.
So 1 to 64, these bits are changed in this fashion. This is inverse, sorry, this is initial permutation. By applying initial permutation, we are performing round 1 operation. After completion of 16 rows, we are performing 32 bit swap. And after completion of 32 bit swap, again we are performing inverse initial permutation. It is very simple to remember. Top part represents even, lower part represents, that is the first 4 represents even numbers, second 4 represents odd numbers. It is easy to remember in the exam. Similarly, for inverse initial permutation, so write 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, so 1 to 8, so in this fashion, next 2. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32. So first write 1 to 32. After completion of 1 to 32, again write 33, 34, 35 and so on. So we are completing total 64. This is the procedure of inverse initial permutations. Now we will discuss single round operation. How it performs in single round. So DS algorithm follows Feistel cipher. Feistel cipher means divide the total plain text into equal number of halves. So our plain text size is 64 bits. Now plain text is divided into two halves. Suppose first half, left half is represented li minus 1. Some right part is represented as ri minus 1. The size of li minus 1 is 32 bits and ri minus 1 size is 32 bits. That is 64 is divided into two parts. Now according to Feistel cipher, left part is fixed as same, perform operation on right part. So here our plain text size is 32 bits. We already discussed the size of key is 48 bits. The size of key is 48 bits. So how the size of key is occurred? Key. Generally, it is divided into two parts, left shift, left circular shift, left circular shift. So total 56, here key size is 56, total 56 bits are divided into two parts, 28 and 28. Each perform left circular shift operation. After performing left circular shift operation, perform permuted choice 2. 28 bits or 28 bits are separately performed. Similar to plain text is divided to 32 halves. Key is also divided into 2 halves. Perform circular shift on each half separately and then apply permuted choice 2. After applying permuted choice 2, it produces 48 bits. That is 56 bits are converted into 48 bits. Now our plain text size is 32 bits. To perform operation, the size of the plain text must be equal to size of key. So for that purpose, we are expanding 32 bits. For that purpose, we are expanding, that is by using some expansion table. or permutation table or E table, we are converting this 32 bits into 48 bits. We are converting this 32 bits into 48 bits. Now perform XOR operation of this 48 bits and permuted choice to 48 bits. After applying XOR operation, again it produces 48 bits. But our plain test size is only 32 bits, but our result is 48 bits. So again perform reduce operation, that is by using substitution or SBOX. By using substitution technique, we are reducing the 48 bit size into 32 bits. Next we will discuss how we are increasing and how we are decreasing. First explain the procedure. 48 bits are converted into 32 bits are applied into permutation. After permutation means that is it simply changes the positions of the bits. Now after changing, that is applied into XOR operation. For XOR operation we require minimum two inputs. One is of 32 bits, next two input is the previous left part is of size 32 bits. By performing it, it produces 32 bits. It acts as RI. It acts as RI and previous RI becomes LI. Previous RI becomes LI. That is LI minus 1, RI minus 1 are the inputs of the first round. After completion of the first round, it produces LI and RI. Previous RI minus 1 simply acts as left part for the next round. And in the same procedure, the key, is also changed into some CI, DI. For example, here the key is CI minus 1, DI minus 1. So this is the procedure of single round. So how we are performing encryption operation by using a key of size 56. Now we will discuss expansion table and S boxes. First expansion table. So here the namespace says the input is 32 bits. Are converted into the 32 bit input is converted into 48 bit. How we are performing that conversion? Simply 1, 2, 3. So 32 bits is divided into blocks. Each block contains 4 bits. So total we have 8 blocks. Total 8 blocks. Now these, so 4, 4, 4, 8 into 4, 32. These 32 is converted into 48. So now block size becomes 6 bits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, the block size becomes 6 bits. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How we fill these 6 bits? Simply place 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. The first 4 bits are occupied, the first 4 bits, and this 5th bit is copied from the previous one. This 5th bit is copied from the previous one. This bit, this is a circular fashion. This bit is copied from the last position, that is from this position. This position bit is copied into this one. Similarly, this position is filled with this one. This position is filled with this one. Similarly, last position is filled with this one. This position is filled with, that position is filled with first one. Now these 4 bits are converted into 32 bits are converted into 48 bits. Suppose if it leads to confusion, simply perform. First to write 1 to 32 bits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32. These are 32 bits. Now these 32 are converted into 48. Simply write 5, 9, 13, 17, 21, 25, 29, 32. After 32, we have to write 1. And before 1, 32, 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, and 28. Now 32 is converted into 48. This is expansion table. After completion of expansion table, we will discuss SBOX. We will discuss SBOX. So XBOS, the input is of size 48 bits. 48 bits is to be converted into 32 bits. 48 bits is converted into 38 bits. In DS algorithm, we have 8 SBOXs. DS algorithm, we have 8 SBOXs. What is the size of SBOX? So each XBOX is represented in matrix format. XBOX is represented in matrix format, rows and columns. We have 4 rows. 8 XBOXs names are S1, S2, S7 and S8. We have 4 rows. Number is 0, 1, 2, 3. And each XBOX contains 16 columns, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on, 15. This is the representation of SBOX. Here each row contains 16 elements. Write the digits from 0 to 15. Write digits from 0 to 15 in any order. Each row we have to write 16 numbers without any conflict. Suppose 1, 2, 0, 3, 7, 4, 9, 10, 11, 13 and so on. In similarly second row also, we have to write your own numbers. But each row contains 16 numbers. This is SBOXs. But how we are converting 48 bits into 32 bits? Suppose 48 bit means it contains 6 bits. We already seen 48 bits, 8 blocks. So 8 into 6 is 48. So each block contains 6 bits. It is converted into 32 bits. 32 bit means block size is 4. In this, the first and last digit represents row number. That is here 1 1. Here 1 1. Suppose this is 1 0. For example, it is 1 0. Now it is 1 0. So the first and last represents row number. Remaining four 0 0 1 0 represents column number. That means 1 0 decimal value is 2 in row 2. 0 0 1 0. Suppose 0 0 1 0 has also 2. So in row 2, in column 2, row 2 and column 2, we have some number. For example, in this position, we have number 8. In row 2, column 2, assume we have number 8. So number 8 binary format is 1000. That is, these 6 bits are converted into these 4 bits. That is, 48 bits are converted into 32 bits in similar fashion. That is, 6 each first and last represents row number, remaining represents column number. So identify this row and this column element. Here 8 test boxes contains 8 different types of values. For first block, that is for first block, we are using S1. Second 6 bits, we are using S2. Last 6 bits, we are using S8. So this is our 32 bits. This is the procedure of DES algorithm. Thank you.